So we are having here in the modules, means in cargo wise, we will be proceeding through a process. Like sales will be creating a quotation or one-off quote. Now once sales will create the quotation or one-off quote, you will, you all people, means whosoever is the concerned user, he will be notified that this business has been won, and you can go ahead with these documents. Okay, so they can either create a quotation or they can either create a one-off quote. Fine. So quotation is based on it's a general quotation. Like it will be having a particular validity. It will be having all your trade lanes with the charges. So if your shipment occurs between that validity, then the quotation is valid for that shipment. Now suppose if he has created a one-off quote, so one-off quote is created when he is aware of the actual data of the shipment, and that one-off quote is one-time quotation. You cannot be going to use that quotation again and again. Fine, so let me check first that any quotations are available there or not for air. No, there's no quotation for air over here. So do you people want me to create a quotation, or can I proceed without quotation? Okay, fine. I will create a quotation. So for creating a quotation, like this is the salesperson job, he is not going to create a quotation directly from here. It's a process. He will be coming from opportunity and then he will create a quotation. So I'm not going from the whole process because it will take a lot of time. I will go to the existing quotation and I will create. Okay, sorry, this has been accepted. Fine, let me create from opportunity. Okay, there is one opportunity created. We go to sales relation, new, sorry, and then quotation. So this is a client. Just a second. There is only one client which is from Singapore. I want one which is from our India. No opportunities have been generated yet. Anyways, I will directly create a quotation because. So I will go and search for a new client, and then here in receivables. So UN loco is unique location code. So each of the port or place has been assigned with a new unique location code. So these locations codes are also available on Google. Okay, there is no client from Bombay. Okay. So I have selected one client, and then in the air freight I will put IN Bombay to USJFK. I will keep via as blank, loose currency INR. I will keep carrier also blank, commodity general, my validity is from today to one month validity is there. Okay, freight, let me take the freight. One freight. Okay, now I will approve. I will close this, means the salesperson will close this, and once this quotation is accepted, he will go here and accept it. Accept. Now you as a user from operations, you have to go inside operate, forwarding, then forwarding bookings. Here we will go to new. Once I will click on new, I will be taken to, okay, system search. So I will be taken to booking with quote. Okay. Here, I will put the same client. Then we can put this consignee as blank. After then I'm having mode. So mode will be air, loose cargo, Incoterms. So I will select Incoterms, any prepaid one. Additional terms, if the client has given you any additional terms, then put the additional terms. Service level standard, shipper reference. Description. So let's take a description as okay. The next we are having marks and numbers.
Ma'am, sorry to interfere.
Yes, yes, Radha. Tell me, Radha.
Screen is not clear. It's, you know, it's blur.
Blur?
Yeah.
Check this. Check again. Is this blurred?
Yes. Please check with others also, no? Because I can see it's blurred.
Anyone else who's getting on the screen blurred?
No, it's very clear to us.
Radha, if you can check your...
No, I'm using Wi-Fi. I can see the screen, but not clear.
Can I make full screen?
Yeah, I can a little zoom it or...
Radha, you see three dots in the middle of the screen. Just click that and enter full screen.
Here you go to full screen.
Yes, sir. I did that. Yes, I just did.
Radha.
Now show the screen. Now I just did full screen.
Is it still blurred? Radha, so you can do one thing.
Clear. If it is, now it is clear.
Okay.
Yes.
Fine.
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Now here is the marks and numbers. So at this booking stage, if you are having any marks and number, put it here. Otherwise, you can keep it blank. Release type. So suppose I want a CWA bill. Charges apply. So you can check that what are the charges you want to be shown on your house survey bill. Okay. The next I am having here origin. It's asking for origin. So this INZZZ, it is taking from the client or consignor.
Excuse me, I have one question. Now you mentioned that release type.
Yes.
Okay, but this is not applicable for air shipment. That CWA bill and all.
Okay.
Because see, once the shipment is done, there is no that release type is applicable, comes into that air export or import shipments.
So you do not release any house?
No, we do release
not CWA bill.
Okay, so okay, fine, sorry. Then is it express bill of lading? What kind of release type?
No, even express bill of lading also not coming to the picture in air shipments.
Okay.
You see, one is direct shipment on master FB bill, and other one is in console agent. Shipment house and master FB bill comes. In console shipment, customer require the house FB bill. For example, if any of the shipment is consigned to bank, then only we can hold the shipment. Otherwise, there is airlines can deliver the consignment to the consignee without the original.
Okay, without the original, without showing original.
In Sunny sir is the right person because I have not much knowledge about the ocean because there is no requirement of a BL release and all, air bill release.
Yes.
Because he, only when it is. Sunny,
yes.
Sorry, go ahead.
Yeah, this is what I am saying, that in air, this is not required, CWA bill and express BL. It's just straightaway BL and master bill in this. BL we can release, air bill we can release to the client from our system. We don't have to go to the shipping line and get the express BL and something like that, or the airline.
No, okay, understood. So Sunny, if you can see here, I am entering this detail for house only, not for the air. Not for the master.
No, but you have mentioned CWA bill, right? You have selected this option, CWA bill.
Sorry for that. If I have selected the wrong thing, if you are if you are releasing original bill of lading, you can select the original bill of lading also. Okay. If express bill of lading, then you can select express. Sorry that I have chosen the wrong one. I'm very sorry for that.
But there's no difference between express and the original in the in air. There's no concept of express and original. This is what we are trying to explain. Yeah.
No, sir. I'm actually what I am aware. I don't know for as of now what is the process going, but when I was customer service in air export, I think 7 years back, at that time we were having the house away bill as the original or express, and we used to deliver it, we used to deliver to the client once the payment is received, like that. So I don't know, sir, right now what's going. So you can guide me better that right now it's only. Yes, Niranjan.
No, see, there is no such process of releasing the airway bill because see that airway bill is required by the customer to submit in their bank to get the remittance from the consignee.
Yes.
Because see, if you are holding the airway bill in that process, there is no control over the cargo. For example, I think in ocean shipment, if you don't submit the BL, release the BL here, then consignee cannot take the delivery of the cargo.
Yes, you are right.
Such process. There is a such condition if the shipment consigned to bank. For example, if one exporter is exporting the consignment XYZ to the foreign country, and if the consignment is consigned to bank, consignee is bank and notify is the consignee.
Okay.
No, not to order. To order will not come in the airway bill. It comes only in the BL. But in air shipment, if you mention the to order, but bank name should be there in the consignee column. Only to order is not allowed. But in such cases, airlines, our overseas partners, the consignment to the consignee, unless until consignee produce the bank release order. So that in such cases, we have to release original shipper copy, our server bill, or master bill, how we are executing the shipment. In such cases, we need to give the airway bill to the customer over here to send that airway bill through their bank to the consignee to get the bank release order. But except that case, all other cases, airway bill, our server bill, master airway bill, original is not required by the consignee to take the delivery of the consignment, which is only required by the shipper over here to submit in their bank to show the proof of exports.
Okay, fine, sir. Understood, sir. Fine. So, like what Niranjan and Sunny has guided us. So here, release type means Niranjan ji, if I'm not wrong, express bill of release type can be default to express bill of lading. If you want to change it, you can change it from this drop down. Suppose if it is
actually, see, as per my experience, that column is not required, only I can say, but still, because the moment, see, air shipment normally reaches in maximum 2 or 3 or 4 days.
Sea
consignment is totally, the transit time is totally different, 15 days, 1 month, more than that sometimes. But air consignment process is totally different. We cannot. Cannot keep that release process. For example, I cannot tell my customer that your BL airway bill is sold because we have to agree the terms and conditions before we execute the shipment.
So, okay, sir. So, Niranjan ji, we can lock this.
Just one thing, Surbhi. We can make it either draft or final.
Draft or final?
We can do that. If it is a draft, then we can do the amendment. If it is final, then it is final. We can give it to the shipper or consignee.
Fine. So for draft, I can I will show you. For the draft, I can show you. But this is a type, means what type of. So anyways, as per current scenario. So what we will do, we will default it. So that it's not required for you to select all the time. Fine. So is that clear for everyone? We will default that to express only.
Okay.
Now, in the origin, you can see here I'm having INZZZ. This is because right now the organization master, which has been uploaded in CargoWise One, the address validation is not done. So it's coming this wrong, means INZZZ. You can see here the error. So what I will do, I will go to this three dot to select the correct code name. It starts with Mumbai. Okay, so I will select this. Then destination. Similarly, you can check for destination. Carrier, we can keep it blank. Then service level we are having. We have not carrier service level is there. So this is standard. We have not defined it. So you can keep it blank. It's not mandatory.
For service level, I think you can add like express, economy, service and all that.
Sorry, sir.
In service, okay, we have different services. Like we have priority service, we have normal service, economy service.
Okay. So, fine. So, Sunny ji, if you can confirm me, is it the carrier service level or is it your company service level?
No, it's carrier service level. We have different rates for different services. If it is priority service, then we get different rates, like express.
Okay. Sudama, if you can make a note of this, that there for the carrier service level, we have to put three different service level. Express and normal and one more economical.
Yeah, economical and normal is same.
Okay.
You can put two, express and normal. And Niranjan, is it okay?
Yeah, right. Yeah, one is normal service, one is express service.
Yeah.
Normal and express. Okay, fine. I will make
instead
a note
of normal, you can put economical, economic service or economical, whatever. Okay. It is.
Yeah. Fine. I will do that. After then we are having estimated pickup, estimated delivery. We can select one estimated pickup. And it is required by today, means that day only. Timing we can change. Estimated delivery, keep it blank. Transit time. Okay, so after entering these details, we are having good details in the bottom. Here, it is asking for outers, means number of packet, weight, volume, chargeable. So chargeable, it will calculate automatically by itself. There is a charge calculation based on like, I think what I remember for the volume, it's LBH if it is in
dimension.
Yes. For dimension, if it is in a centimeter, we used to divide it by 6,000, something like that, no?
Yeah, if it is in centimeter, 6,000. If it is in inches, divided by 366.
Yeah.
So,
that is, those all things have been
Madam,
said.
Madam, before that, I have one query. Just I would like to clarify. For example, now you are showing this page of booking part, right? This will be created once the shipment is confirmed to us.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
Now you mentioned over here transit period, transit time. Is it necessary mention?
Not necessary.
This is for our record here. This is for customer record. Any which way, this is not going to the customer, right?
See, now it's all up to you. If you want to send this booking confirmation to your client, you can send it. Otherwise, it's not required to send the booking confirmation because in air shipment, we don't have that much time. For coordination with the client.
Right, exactly.
So it's not mandatory, sir.
These all fields are not mandatory. You mean to say, right? Transit time and all.
Transit time, estimated pickup. It's not so mandatory, sir.
Okay.
So here we are having the goods details. Okay, at the left side and at the bottom also we are having loose cargo details. So whatever I will put here, it will be going to reflect over here. So like suppose I'm having 10 pallets with 300 kgs. The volume, let's take 100 into 120 and this let's take in centimeter. Now again suppose there are six more pellets are there having 200 or let's take 250 and let's take volume as 120 So now it will ask for the total. So I will select yes. So there are errors. So this is the error from the consignor side is giving. So sir, if you can see here, we can get the total of the weight and the chargeable. What is the chargeable weight?
And where we can enter the dimension?
Sir, see here. Here I am having in the loose cargo, packages, packet type, weight, and then volume. I have not entered anything. I will enter the dimension. So here okay. I have entered the dimension. The volume has been calculated, and here the chargeable weight as per the volume. I think it's on the volumetric shipment is it is. So
if it is in inches, we have to change over here as a
unit. Yes, okay, we will change the unit here and here also. Then it will calculate the right figure.
Now, in case, for example, if you had mentioned that 10 packages dimension separate and 6 pallet dimension separate, and some of the customer is giving my 16 packages weight, total weight, and in this particular loose cargo you had mentioned, no? In that particular column, I don't think so. It is necessary to show the weight of the 10 packages separate because only we require the dimension. Not required that 10 packages weight we need to show separate and dimension separate and 6 packages separate weight dimension and all.
Yes,
because
sir.
If you show, for example, 16, my consignment is consisting 16 packages, I need to show 16 packages altogether and altogether gross weight and dimensions are mean separate. For example, if the dimension is common dimension, then I can show altogether. That's the same dimension for all 16 packages. And if it is different dimension, I have to show separate dimension, but against that no need to show the weight and all weight and number of packages.
Fine, so let me proceed as of now, because suppose if you are having 16 packages are there and you are not aware of the weight. Mm-hmm. Or suppose approximate weight you are aware, so at this level we can put the approximate weight, because once the shipment is custom cleared, then only you come to know what is the actual weight at the airport.
Yeah, that is the altogether weight. They will not take the weight of the individual packages. For example, this would be take some time consuming mentioning the packages gross weight.
That is okay,
because see, in Airway Bill what we required: total number of packages, total gross weight and dimension of all the packages. For example, if all the entire shipment is having similar dimension, then we need to mention once. And if it is a multiple dimension, then we have to show the dimension separate, but not required to show the gross weight of each package.
Yes, you can do it as you are doing on the Airway Bill. Okay.
But these are the mandatory fields to show
No, I think this is not mandatory. We don't have to
optional.
Enter the weight.
Okay.
Yeah, this is optional.
So let me first of all clear the error. There is one more error is there. Now we will just a second. Now we will go inside additional details. So here also we are having the same error. Let's take Bombay. So this is asking for origin and destination, and then we are having load and discharge. ETD, ETA means these all are estimated. If you are aware of ETD, you can put it like 10 plus 2, sorry, today plus 3 means on 13th of May, if you are aware. Otherwise, you can keep it blank. Okay. So similarly, in here, the flight summary. If you know that okay, which flight you are going to book this shipment, then you can add the new flights. Otherwise, this is also not mandatory part. Fine. Then add the. Okay. There is one more, which is house bill number. So you can. You can put the house bill number here, otherwise it will come automatically. Then the next we are having pickup address here. In the pickup address has been taken same as the shipper address, because here you can see we are not having any other addresses mentioned. There is only one address, which is the office address, which is the pickup address. So here it will take the same address. Suppose in the organization master we are having more than one address, and that one address is ticked as a pickup address, so we will have the options to select from here. Delivery address is blank because no consignee details we have mentioned. Next we are having book date. So when this booking has came, you can put the details over here. Client required ETA, warehouse receipt, interim receipt, CFS reference, booking party. You can put the details as per your convenient. Otherwise, you can keep it blank. Okay. Then in the custom field is that this particular tab is present in all the modules. So suppose if there is anything which is missing, any field which is missing in this booking module, so we can create a new custom field from workflow manager. Now in the quote charges, here we are having the quote charges. Here what you have to do for bringing those quotation charges, go to the quote charges at the top and auto rate cost and revenue. So we have not entered any cost, we have just entered the revenue. So we will go and auto rate revenue. So now based on chargeable weight and the charges which we have mentioned at the quotation level, we got this sell rate. Is there any doubt till here? Sunny ji, Niranjan ji, any doubt?
No, I just want to ask you, for every we have to follow this process. We have to make a quotation first.
See, you don't have to make your quotation. Your sales person will make the quotation.
We get an accommodation shipment, for example, for that also first we have to put the rate in the system. First we have to create an opportunity, then quotation, then job.
So for nomination shipment, do you have any salesperson?
No, no, we are only selling it.
So like suppose Sunny.
See, for each and every shipment, there is a salesperson for each and every shipment. Whether it is nomination or whether it is pre-hand shipment. But the question is here, Sunny sir's question is, for example, sold the price directly. Before we start the process of booking, do we need to create the quotation in the system?
Yes.
That means for any shipment, some of the customer is asking, no, I need the quotation by email only. In such cases, we are not going to create the quotation in the system, new system. In such cases, before starting the booking process, is it mandatory to capture the quotation page?
There is not a mandatory thing in CargoWise, but why we are telling you to create a quotation or create one-off quote, this is because one thing is that the rates will remain inside your system for the records. first thing. Second thing is that there will be no mismatch, like for the operations and between means like between the salesperson and the operation, there will be no mismatch of the rates. Okay. The third thing means like there is no manual intervention. You can see here, I just click one thing. I just click auto rate and I got the charges.
No, okay, see, so in air shipment, what happens, I will tell you, for example, for any of one particular destination, now customer is asking multiple airlines rate. Now, even we got the shipment confirmation, we secured the business, everything is okay. Now, till the time we place the booking, we doesn't know which carrier is carrying the shipment on first. Sometimes customer will tell us that you book the shipment on multiple carrier. Now I got the invoice, documents, everything, but customer will tell me that you booked the shipment on three airlines. Whoever is carrying the shipment on first flight, then we will decide and then we will go proceed with that particular airlines. But at this stage, now I got the booking, everything. Now I'm creating the booking page, but even I don't know on which airlines this shipment is finally going on. In okay. such cases, how we will capture this quotation page?
Okay, so sir, in that case where you are not aware of the carrier, that which carrier okay, fine, you are telling that the priority they are giving on the schedules of the flight,
the schedule of the flight, yeah.
And also sometimes we have to, you know, charge some additional charges to the customers. We get to know only after once we hand over the shipment to the airlines and shipment departs from
it. Yes, so Sunny ji, in that yeah, case your user can manually also add. Your user can add it manually. There will be the columns got add on. So your user can do it manually. But Niranjan ji, yours question, I think it's a valid question. Let me check internally and get back to you on this. When the priority is schedules, not the price, in that case, what process we have to follow? So let me check on this, Niranjan ji.
Okay,
but it is advisable to go through this process. Otherwise, you can directly create a booking and consolidate this booking to the master and console and shipment. And there also you can put the charges. Once the carrier is confirmed, you can put the charges manually.
Okay.
Just a second, sir. Let me take that. Once this is done, we will save this. Now, at the top, you can see we are having the file, edit actions. Go to actions and then consolidate it. Once I click on consolidate, I will be taken to this console page. Okay. Now, before proceeding for this, I would like to show. So, Niranjan ji, if you can confirm me, are you getting those available numbers from the
airline? Yeah, all the master available numbers provided by the airlines, only airlines. House available number is our internal number.
Yes, your house. Fine. So, there is one system inside our CargoWise that we can create master available stock inside CargoWise. For that, just a brief about that. What we have to do? We will go to the home. See, at the top there is a home column. We will click here. Go to maintain. Go to reference files. And here we are having master available stocks.
Okay.
So we will click on master available stocks.
Okay.
Here, let me find no data, no records are found. I will go and create new. So my branch will be taken as Mumbai because I have logged in from Mumbai branch. Now here it will ask for airline prefix. So suppose I am doing this for Air India. So once I put airline prefix 098, my airline code will come as AI. I think Air India is providing you the those
numbers,
master bill numbers.
Yeah.
Okay. Now suppose they have given you, suppose I am taking a small quantity because this is a training system. I know everyone will go and they will create this. So I'm just taking suppose 10.
Okay.
Now I will take the number from and to. So let's take it as
Madam, I have one question. Now you count, we have to mention manually. Why not system automatically can count after we mention the number?
Huh?
Why can't system automatically calculate the count, total number of every bill?
What you do, Niranjanji, if you will put the count na 10 and you will put from, just from, and don't put 2, so it will count automatically all.
Okay, that means that now system itself, it will show it. Okay.
Okay.
Now, in certain cases, if I get the, for example, I'm not getting the continuous series then?
Sorry? Sorry, Niranjanji?
In certain cases, airlines issue the stock continuous series. For example, always available number, last number, no, 0 to 6 only. Never ever available number, that master available number will come 7 or more. That is from 0 to 6 only. For example, in my case, that one stock is different series and second stock is different series, then in such cases, I have to mention means 1-1 entry, right, in the system?
Niranjani, if you can provide me that particular scenario, then I can check.
Okay, we will discuss this separately later on.
Yes, like okay, how you are getting those stocks? Fine.
Okay. No. Okay. That we will see. It is not a big thing. We can discuss this matter later also. No problem.
Okay. So once this is done, I will save this.
What is this borrowed from?
This is like suppose if you borrow from any other, like suppose for this airline you have borrowed this from any other organization, you can put the organization name. Or any other agencies, if you have borrowed, you can put that agency's name.
Okay, that means printing on the available that airline's name will come. But for example, this is our internal reference. For example, today I am in Mumbai. I have direct contact with the airlines Air India, and we are getting the stock of Air India. For any of the reason, if I am taking in Mumbai branch also someone else Air India's available. And executing the shipment in my system, in such cases, I have to mention that person's name in the borrowed from, right?
Yes, okay, yes, or that agency's name.
Okay, fine, understood,
So I will close this and now you can see. Niranjanji, see here, I'm having the set of 6 only. The number will not exceed from 6.
Yeah, right.
Okay, now. This has been done. Any doubt for master available stock, anyone else? Radha, Taniji, Bhushan.
No, it's okay.
No.
Okay. So let me proceed. So now I'm back to this screen console details for booking. Anybody having any other doubt other than Niranjan's scenario? Anybody having any other doubt?
Surbhi, this booking will give us a job number.
That booking will, yes, that booking will give you the job number once you consolidate it.
Okay.
Consolidate means you mean to say that ki all the information we are merging in one page, after that job number will create, right?
Yes, exactly. So this is the console details. So first of all, it is asking for type. What type? So we are having agent, or if it is direct shipment, we can choose direct shipment also. The next is the charter, which I have not used, and I have not seen any client using for the charter. Then courier, other, available, co-load is there. So you can select as per whatever business you are going to do. So here, suppose if I select agent, if it is agent directed shipment, so we will select agent. Transport is air, container mode will be loose. First load Bombay to New York. Now it will ask for flight details. So let's, I think for Bombay, what is the flight number, sir? If you remember, Bombay to New York, AI. 101?
I think 142 or something like that. It's good. Yeah.
So these aircraft type and aircraft registration number, these are not mandatory. If you are having those information, you can put it. Otherwise, it's not mandatory. The flight number is required. ETD is 13th May. I think it's a direct shipment. So then ATD means actual time of departure. ATA is actual time of arrival. The next we are having service level. So this is the carrier means service level. So what you have told us, we will create that and we will get that over here. Now here the payment it's asking, it will be always prepaid. I think for airline, it's always prepaid.
Right.
The next we are having master available. It's 098 and it will show pending allocation. Okay. So we will keep it like this. Now here in the sending agent, let's put sending agent SAR transport and receiving agent as RTW. Carrier, I don't know whether the carrier has been created or not. Sorry. They check any airline. Okay. Name starts with Air. Air India Limited. Okay. Once this is done, the next, it will ask for creditor. So if Air India itself is a creditor or any other organization master is there for the creditor of Air India, you can put it over here. Otherwise, it's not required. Means it's required at the time of booking the cost. So the next we are having departure. Under departure, you will get CTO address, CFS address. So these all information, if you are having, you can put. Otherwise, you can keep it blank. For arrival also, we are having the same. If you are having those information, put it. Otherwise, you can keep it blank. The next we are having docs. So here in the docs, these all things have came by default. So manifest print all print option for other docs. So this will be all available dimension, fall back to volume, original bills, release type. So sir, is it required here release type, or we can means is it required to put the release type here?
No, I think draft or original.
Draft and those things I will show you.
Okay.
Yeah, that I will show you. Then charges apply. Here we are having some drop downs in the charges applied that do not replace rate amounts with as agreed on both the sets, or replace all charges with as agreed. So are you having the rated house master available, or you are having as agreed, or both?
The master is rated, house is as agreed, but sometimes house is also rated.
Sometimes it is rated. Just a second, sir. So suppose if it is rated, in that case we can put here the chargeable rate. Okay, suppose if I put here 5, then when I will take you inside master available, then you can see that the chargeable weight got multiplied by this chargeable rate. Okay, here we are having some special handling instructions. So you can select whatever you want to select here. Fine. Now in the routing tab, I am having a status as planned, and these all details came from the details section flights. Containers, we don't want any containers. Now here you can see we are having one available tab. Okay, so now in the docs we have mentioned the chargeable rate. Similarly, there is one console costing. Now in the console costing also you can enter the charge codes, means charge codes which you have charges which you have received from the carrier, from airlines. Okay, you can put it over here also if you are having all those charges. Otherwise I have kept here chargeable rate as 5. Now we are having here available. So once I click on available, I have been taken to this page. Here I am having, in the available you can see there is a blue envelope developed here. This means that there is some error in this, like issuing carrier's agent name and city, agent's ITA code. So like your organization master is still under process, that's why it's giving you the error. Now see here what we have mentioned. Chargeable weight, then rate, and that it then it got multiplied. Now here at the top, master available allocation is still pending. So let's save this. And let's go to the detail section. So see, previously it was showing that pending allocation. Now once you will save this job, you will get the allocation here for master, from the master available stock. Any doubt till here?
If I created one booking and in that one I put one particular available number like Air India. Now in the same job, for some reason that shipment is not going on that particular airlines and I have to change the available number as well as airlines. In such case, is it editable?
This is not editable. The master available is not editable once it is used. But suppose any other airlines you have created, in that case you can change it, like you can create a new console.
That means even for change of airlines also I have to create a new console. After creating the booking number, I cannot edit and change the available number.
Yes sir,
but can we use the first one again, the Air India one?
Yes, you can use that one again. You can change the dates and suppose if the destination is also changed, you can change that and you can use this.
No, madam, my question is, for example, I fed the all the information like shipper, consignee, destination, gross weight, packages, everything. My booking is also there on Air India. Now all of a sudden, for some reason, Air India has cancelled their flight, suspended their flight.
Okay.
Now same shipment, I need to send it on other airlines, for example, British Airways. But my data, all the information is going to remain the same. To just change the airlines, I need to create the new booking. Yeah, will I able to change the available number in that particular job?
Sir, you can change the available number. Just a second, let me show you. Suppose this airline, suppose it has gone, it is going on British Airways. So may I know the
BA?
BA, na?
125.
Yeah. 125. Its available is also 125.
Yeah.
Able, so, yes.
But in this case, 125 is the prefix of British Airways. Yeah, right.
Means a prefix.
Yeah.
So in this case, we have not created any master available stock. Okay. So what I will do, I will untick the neutral master available and I can 125 and I can put the master available number. Or suppose British Airways is giving you the master available stock, in that case you can create master available stock and this will automatically come here with neutral available ticked.
In the same booking number I can change
the available. In the same, yes, in the
okay.
same.
Okay, for suppose if that particular salesperson has created the quotation in the system and he has not quoted on British Airways and this particular shipment, now we finally, since Air India suspended their flight, we are forwarding the shipment on British Airways. In yeah. such cases, do we need to go back to the quotation page and all and change the rate part and all?
No. Suppose that salesperson has not quoted on a particular carrier. Suppose the salesperson has not quoted on any of the carrier, without any carrier if he has quoted, because sometimes the clients, they do not very much interested in knowing the airlines. They will tell that, okay, whichever is having the lesser transit time, you can go ahead with that. So in that case, it's not based on any carrier. You are not required to change that in the quotation level.
No. My question is, madam, for example, my salesperson has offered the rate on Air India. He has offered the rate of, for example, 100 rupees per kg. Now, while creating this booking page, we have to capture that information also on which airline this shipment is going. Just imagine now almost shipment is done, but at the last moment we come to know that Air India has suspended the flight. Now we have to move the shipment on other carrier. But that in that particular quotation, whatever we given to the customer, no, in that British Airways rate was not quoted. But whatever the rate we had quoted, that system will capture, right, while creating the booking. But at the last moment, I am changing the airlines from Air India to British Airways. That rate is different. In such cases, do we need to go back to that quotation page? Because the cost will mismatch, no? Because we had offered the rate on Air India. Now shipment is going on British Airways. That cost may be less or more. But it is not the same. In such cases, what we need to do?
Sir, see, in that case, na, what happened? Your salesperson will also be going to inform customer. So how will they inform? Will they inform on phone or on mail or from cargo wise? If they are informing from cargo wise, then you simply have to click on auto rating and the charges will come over there. Okay, but if he is quoting from mail or anything else, in that case you have to do the entry manual entry you have to do in that case.
Okay.
So sir, see, these last minute things which you are telling, like the last minute if the carrier is changed, so like, see, these scenarios we were not discussed earlier. So let me check these part, that how to tackle
because
these.
Because see, part. In air freight, no, madam, in short period, anything can happen. For example, Air India has quoted the rate because they are giving the rate with the subject to space. For example, they had given rate, if just imagine 100 rupees per kg for London. They have daily flights to London, example. Now my customer has confirmed the shipment. All of a sudden, Air India has got huge demand, and all of a sudden they can increase the rate also. They can say tomorrow, no, I had quoted 100 rupees, but now we have more demand. I cannot confirm your space with the 100 rupees rate. My rate has increased to 200 rupees. Means not only cancelling the flight in air shipment in such a short period. No, these are the difficulties we are facing. In such cases, we just need to know how to process in the systems.
Short notice one.
Yeah, in short notice. To, yeah, anything can happen, madam.
I need to discuss that, Niranjan ji.
With, okay, fine. No
internally.
Problem.
Yes, yeah, but no, this no is problem. Good. But this is good if you are putting such kind of scenario so that I can ask, and when you will go live at that time, these difficulties you and your user will not face, that what you have to do at that time.
See, for example, one customer service operation guy is creating this booking. To just change the available with the same booking number, it is easier for us. Even that changing the quotation also in that particular booking only, by editing the airline's name, yeah, freight rate, he will update proper data. But in that case, if you need create new booking, then it is a very time consuming. It is very difficult for us.
Fine, Niranjan ji. Let me check that for that last moment. Na? Otherwise, if suppose carrier is changed, then we can change the carrier from here. And also you can allocate, you can have your master available stock for British Airways. So from here only we can get the AWA bill and security declaration. You can check, Sunny ji, Niranjan ji, you can check here. This will be the AWA bill.
Okay.
Okay. And this will be the security declaration.
In that AWA bill, can you please go back to that page, previous one? See, for example, now you go to the shipper column or consignee column. Now some of the shipments, what happens, you know, for example, my customer is, I will take any of the customer, for example, Glenmark Pharmaceuticals. Now their organization master has been created in the system. Now, for example, they have some LC shipment, letter of credit. In that comma, full stop, everything has to be as per the LC terms, LC copy, whatever they had given. Otherwise, there should be a bank is charging penalty and all. In such cases, how we can do that? Is it editable in this page? Yeah, we have to go back to the master page.
See, we have both the options. You can override this also.
Okay.
Just a second. First is this. Check this if you want to override default values.
Okay.
The next you are getting here. Override.
If I override it, that master detail will remain the same. Only here it will change, right?
Yes, only here it will change.
Okay. As per customer's requirement, we can print on the available. However, the master, that file will remain the same. There will not change anything.
No, that will not change in the master. It will get changed over here. But yes, whosoever is handling that master, he will be notified that address or something has been changed while using it in the job. Okay.
Okay. Once it is changed, after that, if we save and send it to the customer for approval, then again they will tell us that to change some more changes. That time that page will means whatever we have changed, edited, that will remain the same, right?
That will remain the same. You will save this. What errors? Just a second. No master bill in the stock to allocate. Okay. Let me change this to 098 only.
Fine,
because
okay.
The no master available stock is there. Let me save this. So now suppose here you change anything and then you save this. After then go to the documents. In the documents, we are having available. So here I am having neutral master available. So we'll go here. We can preview. So these will be in the draft. Sorry. Unless you print the final master, it will be in the draft. Like there are, now I don't know that which master available you are using. Is it the neutral one?
Yeah, master available neutral one in the sense you mean to say that our A4 size printing on the A4 size paper, right?
Huh.
Yeah, most of 99% is the neutral available now.
Neutral, na?
Okay. Yeah.
So, we will preview this. And we can print it out. Or if you want to send it to, sorry, I will not print. If you want to send it to your email, you can put your email over there. Just a second. I will show you. So, here in the delivery tab, we are having a drop-down. Select email. You can email it to your ID. In the suppose if you want it in the PDF form or Excel form, whatever form if you want, you can select this and send from and send to whatever your ID, you put it and then you can deliver it to your ID.
Okay, send from means, for example, if I am the user, while sending it from the system, that my email ID will come
your
here.
Your email
system
ID will come.
Okay.
Your email ID will.
Okay, I can manually put customer's email ID over here, right? That is senders.
You can put customer's email ID or like this is the, see, this is the AWA bill. So master AWA bill. So I don't know whether you are sending this to the client also. But yes,
you can send it to internally also, means within, means
you can send it internally. You can put the email ID of whosoever and you can deliver from here. You can deliver it.
Okay.
Similarly, we are having security declaration under AWA bill in the documents under AWA bill, AWA bill security declaration. So preview, so Niranjan ji, if you can confirm me any other document you are sending initially at the time of sending that master AWA bill and security declaration. Other than that, there is something called GSP or
No, see, security declaration is not required at destination. That we will have to submit while handing over the cargo to the airlines. At the time of acceptance, they will check whether all the security letters are there in place. Otherwise, they will not, because see, it is like area wise. For example, if the shipment goes to USA, apart from general security declaration, we have to give some more security declaration. Likewise, area 2. Area 3, depends, airlines to airlines, there are different security, apart from one general security declaration, we have to give some other supporting declarations as well. And apart from that, we have to give non-hazardous declaration for the non-hazardous, non-DGR shipments. These are required by the airlines. And you are talking about GSP and all, no? GSP basically, see, it is shipper's responsibility to send it to their buyer, which is required by the consignee at destination to clear the goods. But most of the Indian customer, what they do, they give it to the forwarder to save the cost. But any of the airlines is not responsible for all these additional documents, we are sending along with the consignment.
Yeah, like a certificate of origin or
certificate
GSP,
of origin, GSP, whatever
that it is. I remember that we used to send it on behalf of the shipper. The airline was not responsible for that. But we used to include it in the pouch with all those documents.
Right.
So, sir, I'm talking about initially only, that initially at the time of handing over your goods, you required to get one is the AWA bill, another is the security declaration. So these two things are available here.
Okay, what about the backside of the term, that IATA terms and condition?
The
reverse side of the AWA bill, it will be printed. How it is? We have to take the Xerox.
Sir, that I need. Just a second. Let me print final master. Once I print final master. Okay, this is a training, na? Okay, means that is something which we cannot. That is the print final master, so that we cannot see.
Okay.
It has been gone to the, let me check.
Now you shown one, the draft AWA bill. I think below that there is a terms and condition. I have seen that. Can you show me that draft again? below that scroll it down. Okay, there is no. Oh, there is only the front page.
Front page is only. Just a second. There are some cover pages there in the laser available. So is this the terms and conditions?
No, that we'll have to check. If it is possible to send it across to my email?
I can send you the.
I think this is the cargo-wise terms and condition. I think not that which what we are talking about the IATA terms and conditions.
IATA terms and conditions. Sudama, there is one IATA terms and conditions in the registry, na?
Yes, it is appearing by default.
So that we have to send to Niranjan ji and Sunny ji. Okay,
I will send this document.
So till here, any other doubt? Terms and condition, Niranjan ji, I will send it to you.
Okay.
After this call, anyone else? Any doubt?
And Surbhi, yes, what about manifest?
Manifest.
I think the security declaration which we were showing now, that is the manifest. That's not the security declaration.
There is one.
Okay.
There is one manifest here.
Okay.
You can see.
Okay.
Okay.
Right. Okay.
Any other doubt? Hello? Yes, Sunny.
That's fine. You can go.
Oh.
Jaimin, Krishna, if you have any doubt, koi sab log puch sakte hai. Krishna?
No, sir.
No, na?
Okay, no.
Okay, Jaimin.
No, proceed. We can proceed further.
Okay. Sandesh. Okay, carry on.
Fine, so.
Yes. Just one question. Can we add multiple houses with a master?
Uh-huh.
Like if uh-huh. a console shipment in that case?
Yes. Like if this is a console and suppose there are in one MBL you are having 10 or 15 different house servable.
Okay.
Sorry, my screen is not visible. Okay, just a second, Sachin. Yeah, suppose this is a one master and there are 10 or 15 shipments there. In that case, we can create the new shipments here.
Okay.
And also there is an option for buyer consolidation option that I am coming here. Save this. So whatever you are going to print final or deliver to the client, all those things will get attached over here in the eDocs. Even we can save the documents in the eDocs, like add eDocs, or we can, if it is available on the, you know, like email, then we can drag and drop here.
Okay.
So now I'm going inside the shipment. There is the shipment. I will select the shipment and edit. So this will be the shipment screen. The first one is we are having mode. Now here in the mode, I'm having transport mode as air. Container is the loose and type is a standard house. So in the type, we can select other if we are having like buyer consolidation. I think there must be some shipments for buyer consolidation. Then we are having assembly master, third party ownership for switch BLs and all. So we can select accordingly. The next we are having consigner. Then now if you are aware of consignee, we have to put here the consignee details. Now here in the details tab, we are having house bill. It has taken automatically, but this is editable. You can edit it. Okay, suppose any agent has given you their house available prefix, you can put over here. Then origin, destination and ETD, ETA, it has taken the same from master available. Weight, volume, chargeable, these all have taken from booking from where we have entered all these details. Goods value, insurance value, if you are having, put it here or we can keep it blank. Then we are having description for the shipment. So we can enter the description. Incoterms, we have selected CIF. Additional terms, I have chosen there. This means manually entered. I have manually entered this SF2589. Spot rates are there. Then we are having service levels. So this is the service levels which SAR Group is offering to the clients. Next, we are having entry details. So this is related to customs. Inspection, it's unknown. Then available dimension is default. So we are having a few more options, but we used to take default. If there is no dimensions, then fall back to volume. Charges apply. So here we are having do not replace any amount with as agreed. So in your cases, sir, what are the charges? Is it a rated house or as agreed?
sometimes is rated, sometimes as agreed. It depends on the customer or the client.
Huh.
Like we do Gazi shipments and there we have to send rated house.
Okay, fine.
Yes.
So, fine. So, suppose if it is as agreed, then we are having here the option for as agreed, or we are having charges apply. So, do not replace rate amounts with as agreed for both the sets. So, we will select this one.
Okay,
this is the screening status. Screening status is related to the denied party screening. So yet any denied party screening has not done. So this screening can be done for whole of the job. So whatever organization has been entered here, for all those organization screening can be done. Phases is that which is related to the security. Means like suppose if export department or air export department has done this, so they can lock this shipment so that nobody else from any other department come here and edit any details. Okay. Next, okay, sorry. Now at the right side, we are having custom field. So this is the same which I have discussed at the booking stage, that any field, suppose any of the fields which are missing over here, then in that case, we can create a custom field from workflow manager. Here we are having order reference. So orders, if you are aware of any PO number, you can put it here, or it's not mandatory. So these are the fields which are given, and these are all are the fields which are given for air export. These fields can also be like, means there are some more fields which we can design as per you. There are some more fields which we can add on here, or there are some fields which are not of your use. We can remove those fields. Fine.
Okay.
Next, we are having additional details. Under additional details, I'm having the first column as consolidation details. So this is the same console from where we have arrived here. So you can select this console and you can edit it. Once you click here, you will be taken to that console page. This is the weight, volume and chargeable details. Then here we are having notify party. We can select the notify party if there is any notify. Services, any kind of services, if you are availing from any contractor, you can put here. And we can also add some more options if you want, if any option is not there. The next, here we are having reference numbers. So reference numbers, like there are certain numbers, if you want to put it here, you can put. These all are the numbers. And if any numbers or any number type is missing, so you can tell us, we can add, means we can add it from registry settings. Routing. So routing tab, it has taken from console only. See, it is defined by console. Suppose from JFK, it is going to Chicago via road or something, then we can add over here. And we can select the appropriate mode. Suppose if it is going from road, we can select the road, and we can then enter the load and discharge, and then ETD, ETA. The next I'm having packing. So for the packing, Here we can mention the correct details, whatever we are having, the correct details, like this is something which has been taken from booking details. Now suppose if you if there is any changes, then we can change from here also. The same thing will get combined and that will be reflecting at the basic registration screen here. All those things will get totaled together and it will reflect here. Pickup and delivery, these are the tabs where you can enter. Suppose any pickup agent you want to enter or any pickup transport company. Or yes, these like pickup transport company, these things can also come from that relationship. Suppose if there is any relationship we have developed under this consignor. So the pickup transport company can come from there. Here it has taken pickup from. It has already taken from the shipper by default, but this is also editable. You can edit it. Here you can see pickup required by. So pickup is required by 11th May as I have selected. And estimated pickup. Means pickup required by 11th May, 22 hours, and estimated pickup I have selected at 20 hours, 6 minutes. Same thing we are having here in the delivery. Here also you can put the details, whatever you are having. Once this is done, we can save this. Yes, once you will save this, it will ask, do you wish to save this supplier, consigner or buyer consignee relationship? Means this R&M sales and that consigner. Do you want to save their relationship? So all the time when a new supplier and a new buyer is there, it will ask you before saving the shipment file. So suppose if I select it yes, then I will show you. If I select it yes, means I have selected if consigner will be this, I will get this consignee. If this will be a consignee, I will get consigner as this. That I will show you here in the consigner organization if we will go. Select this, edit this, and then go to consigner and go to consignee buyer imported defaults. You see here, we got that consignee details over here. Okay. Then if we will come here in the billing screen, we will get the same billing from booking screen. Here we are having local client, the same local client. Local client, it's always taking from the Incoterms. So if my Incoterms is prepaid, so it has taken it local client as a consigner, overseas agent as RTW New York. Then we are having job description here, open date and close date, branch, department, job status is still working, sales rep, means like in the organization level, we have not set any sales representative. So it will show a blank here, but we can put it manually also like. Just a second. Okay. Operations rep, it will automatically came as SFL because I am working on this job. So it will automatically come as operations rep as SFL. Now here what happened when I have, if you have seen, when I have done that auto rate revenue, then cost also came the same. This is because this freight charge is having 100% margin. but the cost you can edit it, like you can edit it. Suppose and let's put creditor as So it will by default take creditor as Air India if the Air India has been ticked as payable. But as of now, I don't think that Air India has been taken as payables. That's why it's not coming. So I will select payables. That name starts with Air. Results. So I don't get any Air India payables here in the database. So let me select any other option.
While entering the Airbill stock, if you don't put that borrower from others, then automatically Air India should be the creditor. No, it should be. Once you enter the Airbill number, by default, it has to come, no, madam, instead of mentioning that.
Yes. But Niranjan ji, you see what happened here. If I... yes. Just a second, Niranjan. If I mention... Air India. So Air India as of now in your database is carrier. It's not selected as a payable. That's why it's not giving me the option. If it is, it has been selected as a payables, it has been selected as a debtor in the organization master, then it will automatically going to populate there in the creditor option. Okay, Niranjan ji.
Okay.
Because in the database, see, in your cargo buys, how come cargo buys will know that Air India is the creditor? Until unless you will not take it as a creditor. Okay. So as of now, I'm going to select any other one, which is from India, I suppose. So once I selected the creditor, although creditor will come by default, but I have selected here because as of now, that airline has not been selected as a payables. Now, if you will see, we have not posted the invoice yet. Okay, I have got the profit of 11,808 as INR. Now I will go to job invoicing at the top. Click here and then post local client charges. Fine. Now here you see, we are having job status as WRK. And here you can edit these things. But once we select post local client charges. Okay. So once I will select post local client charges, you can see it has been grayed out. And it will ask, do you want to print the invoice? If I will select yes, then this window will open. We can preview. So this will be your invoice for BSV shipping agencies. Who is your client? Fine. Till here. Till this invoice part, is it clear?
Yeah, I think it is okay. Once we'll do it, then we'll get to know better.
Yeah, yeah, sure. Now, I will quickly go into the house available to show. So here in the additional details, we can view and edit available. Okay, so here is the button to view and edit available. Just go inside it. And you can see this savable. Okay. So this is a available for you to go and view this. To you can edit this.
In the available, I have two queries. One is, for example, if you select the freight, prepaid or collect, that in the accounting information column, automatically it should be printed. That is one.
No. Just a second. Where we will select freight, prepaid and collect?
But how we will come to know this available is prepaid or collect? For example, here in charges column, it's a prepaid, but the same information has to be printed in accounting information column of the available as well.
Okay, just a second. You are talking about house available only?
No, master as well as house, both.
Okay, right now I'm showing is the house available.
Okay, for example, if I selected the charges code as a collect CC, in that case, that information in full form, freight collect or freight prepaid, has to be printed on the AVE bill, accounting information column of the AVE bill.
Okay, just a second. So here we are having total prepaid.
Yeah, that is okay, madam. That is pre-printed column, that if you say any of the AVE bill, non-noted AVE bill, it is printed, total prepaid, total collect.
Okay, you want a proper means it should be written as a, this is a prepaid available.
Yeah, because see, the concern issuing carrier column is there, no? Issuing carrier agent's name and city.
Yes.
Rights out of that column is in the same line, accounting info only type. It is actually, it should be in full form, accounting information. Below that, if you see any of the available, we have the copy, we can send you the draft as well. It should be printed like that.
Okay, fine. So that I will check. The next query.
Next is, apart from freight charges, now you had mentioned that 16 pieces, 550 kg, you had mentioned the freight as 22. Apart from that, there are some charges in the due agent as well as due carrier. How to put that?
Okay. Like suppose if there are other charges, so you can... Here also we are having other charges option. Plus, there is like in
can
the
you show
chart,
an example how to may put that charges, other charges?
Okay, just a second. Suppose if I want OTHC. Okay. What I will do, I will select this. And I will right click and then I'm having one quick calculate. So let me calculate based on weight. Let me put it as a now, there are certain settings that we have to do. One is inside this charge code. It's not coming here. Just a second, let me check. Because there are certain charge codes which we need to link it with the IATA codes under the charge codes option. So here I'm not getting that option. And there is also one registry settings there that we have to do, and then we will be able to get that those rates inside house available. Let me check. I don't think the registry settings have been. This is the one which we have to do the correction in the registry, and then use current use. Once I have selected this, there is only this one. See, here I'm having the charge code BAF, and at the side I got the IATA code. So like if it's airway bill fee, so BAF is not applicable in the IATA code. Just a second. I think FSC is there. Just a second, let me check. Fuel surcharge. So you are talking about this due carrier. Whose question was that?
Yes, he's asking for that only.
Okay.
Fuel secured, fuel charges, security charges, then X-ray charges are there.
Okay. Fuel charges, I have. Yeah. Let's look at whether it's coming or not, because there are a few more settings, I guess, from the registry. Yes, charges are coming in the other charges, if you can see. Sorry, whose question was that? I could not recall the name.
Hello.
Yes. Yes, Sunny ji.
Yes, Niranjan asked this question, but this is the common, okay. Like for every way we need this charges.
Okay.
Yeah.
So here we are getting the charges. You see here, you can see I have entered the two charges. One is OTHC, origin terminal handling, and second is fuel surcharge. So the fuel surcharge, I have mapped it with the IATA charge code, and the other one I have not mapped. So its charge code is coming as blank. Here also it's coming prepaid. And suppose if you want to override, you can select this and you can override charges over here.
Okay. Right.
Niranjan ji, are you there?
Yeah, I'm there, yeah.
Yes, Niranjan ji. You can
see,
tell
actually
me
that no need to that printing of the full form, like original terminal handling, fuel surcharge, it is not required. Actually, if you mention 2 or 3 letter code, no, that is well enough.
So and, see Niranjan ji, the charge codes are from the IATA charge codes, like MY is for fuel surcharge. Now,
no, it is not necessary. For example, fuel surcharge also, no, it is varied to airlines to airlines. For example, some of the airlines will give us the circular that key that fuel surcharge code should be MOIC. Some of the airlines will tell you that it should be FSC, because not all the airlines are same for that even particular one charge also.
Okay, so we can do the correction over here also, Niranjan ji.
Okay.
This has came because this was set up in your database. In RTW or SAR group cargo wise database, the description has been set up as fuel surcharge.
Okay.
Or suppose if you want to change it from the system, you don't want to do it manually, you can put it on the email so that we can discuss with Abhijit ji and whosoever is taking care of accounts.
Okay, but how that system will segregate the charges, due agent and due carrier charges? Based on what what basis it will segregate?
If you have seen that process, we have to map those charges with the charge codes which are present within the system.
Okay.
And after, just a second. Now, once this is done, we will go into the documents at the top. Save the record. We will save this. Go to documents.
Okay.
In the available, we are having neutral house available. This will come in this way for neutral. Okay, Niranjan ji?
Okay.
we can have a laser house available. So like house available number, it's giving us blank because I have not entered any house available number. I have deleted there.
Yeah, this is the condition of contract. This is what I was asking.
Okay. Fine. So we will send you this document, Niranjanji.
Okay, and, fine. No problem. And this copy now, for example, see, if you see the bottom of the EBA bill, no? There is a original 2 for shipper, 3 for shipper and consignee, that all the copies will print, right?
I'm so sorry.
No, it is okay, it is okay.
I'm so sorry, sir. Just a sec. Chup. Okay, so yes, sir, these all will be print. Any other document which you are sending to your client?
See, client in the sense here for shipper, we are sending the shipper copy of the EBA bill. That is the original, has to go to the shipper. And in the pouch, whether it is control shipment or direct shipment, that consignee, delivery receipt, airport of destination. These are the documents has to be handed over to the airlines while handing over the shipment.
Okay.
Of the master copy as well as in the pouch, that consignee copy, delivery receipt, it has to be inserted in the pouch.
Okay.
Rest of the means extra copies, which is not required.
Okay. So, sir, I will be sending all these 8 copies to you. You can tell us that what are not required.
Okay, no problem. You send me that all the files. I will check and let you know.
Okay. And anything else? Any other document?
See, your documents you're talking about, there are various documents. Like one is what we are handing over to the airlines, in which that EBA bill copies and declarations will come. And document one, that EBA bill copies, we are sending it to the shipper over here. That is the shipper copy. That is a non-negotiable document. And apart from that, consignee, delivery receipt, airport of destination, and issuing carrier copy. These are the copies goes to the airlines. And while delivering the goods, they will take the signature from the, it has to go delivery receipt. And one copy is airport of destination, that goes to the final destination. That airlines, they will retain the copy. These are the copies we have to hand over while handing over the goods to the airlines.
So you are talking about house available copies, these all?
We cannot give both to the customer. In console shipment, only house available copy we are giving to the customer at origin. Whichever the port of loading, and apart from that, consignee and delivery copy will go in the consignee pouch. And for airlines required, airlines will not ask what you put in the pouch, house of a bill. I will not bother about the house of a bill. They are concerned with only the master of a bill. That master of a bill copy is what they require, that we have to hand over to the airlines. But they will not, for example, in console shipment, in the pouch, whether we put or we don't put, they will not ask what are the copies you put in the pouch. But whatever required, the master will copies. If it is incomplete, at origin, for example, if I'm handing over the goods at Mumbai, they will check that airport of destination, consignee, delivery received, these are the copies, and issuing carrier copy. Certain airlines will ask this agent copy, issuing carrier copy. They will accept at the end while accepting the shipment, and some of the airlines will accept that copy while reporting the cargo sales report.
Okay.
That is depends, because their airlines will give you the pre advice how to hand over that copy.
Mm-hmm.
Pre instruction.
Okay. Fine. So. I think.
See, segregation of copies. No, that uh-huh. It is manual thing. That we can do manual, but what are the copies we required from the system generated, that we will check and let you know. But see, whatever now you trained us, we will come to know only after practically doing it.
Yes, sir.
We have to do one live job from the beginning to till the end. Then only we will come to know what are the changes to be made and what are the addition to be made.
Yes, you're right. So I would expect tomorrow to be the hands-on
with all those scenarios.
Yeah. Okay. Fine. We will do one live job tomorrow instead of going step by step. We can do it in two part also. See, today it is almost 3 hours we took. What we will do tomorrow, we will do one part, and day after tomorrow we'll do one part. We'll complete the process. And one more session, we will see what are the changes to, we will discuss about that. In that way, we can arrange the training.
Fine. Okay, so.
Correct, no, Sunny, sir?
It's okay, it's fine with me. Yes, correct.
एक ही सेशन में अपन 2-3 घंटा वेस्ट करने से अच्छा, आई मीन वेस्ट इन द सेंस किसी को कुछ आवर भी रहेगा, इसी के लिए बोल रहा हूँ. अपन 1.5 hour 2 hour मतलब वी विल गो स्टेप बाय स्टेप. इफ एनीथिंग इज लेफ्ट देन वी विल कीप इट इन द नेक्स्ट सेशन.
यस, नो प्रॉब्लम.
यस यस,
ठीक है,
विल डू दैट.
फाइन, सो टुमारो आई विल एक्सपेक्ट एवरीवन टू पार्टिसिपेट. And please log in and see that whether the security rights have been given correctly or not. If you are not, if you are getting stuck anywhere within the system, so please send me with a screenshot. Okay, so that I can do the, means myself or my team can do the correction and give you the proper security rights.
Yeah, because this is not being installed on my system yet. I'm in contact with Shirish.
Okay.
I'm facing some problem. I've already highlighted to him, and he said he'll sort it out. I don't know whether he has discussed with you or not. I'll speak to him tomorrow.
I have received one mail from Ranjit. Not from him. Maybe in this 2 hours, maybe he has mailed me. I have not checked that mail. So if this has not been resolved today, please add me in that email. Okay. Myself, right. Or Sudama, then I will. Okay. We will make the correction, and you can do some hands-on there. Okay.
Tomorrow we will do one live job, and we will ask everyone. If anyone has the doubt, we'll stop and we'll explain it properly.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. Sure. No issues.
Okay.
Right. Okay.
Okay. Fine.
Okay. Thank you, everyone. Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you, everyone, for participating.
All right. Thank you.
Thanks. Bye.
Okay. Bye.